NAB 2022. How we doing? I'm Dasi Steins. I'm a quality engineer on the After Effects and Premiere teams for motion graphics templates. And we're going to be talking a lot about what we've been up to in the last few years. So we've been working on multi-frame rendering, and that is one of the biggest stories that is not like flashy, but it's going to make your life better. Like basically, we've brought After Effects into the modern day, and now so many things will make your life so much faster. It's so much faster on the M1. We also worked really hard to port all of that code to work not on the Intel-based system and via Rosetta, but actually to be running natively on the Apple machines. And so everything is turned super lightning fast. But as I mentioned, I work on motion graphics templates, which we sort of made as a way to bring more complicated After Effects projects into Premiere Pro. Really, this story, everything, it has an origin story. And for motion graphics templates, that origin story is After Effects, and it's in the Essential Graphics panel. And this has become a place where I feel so much redundant work with a little bit of like upfront effort and investment, you can save yourself so much time. There's a lot that you can do in After Effects utilizing this core engine that we created for that purpose. So let's dive in. One of the latest things that we worked on that I feel really proud about is something that we call media replacement. It started out as like, oh, hey, like I have a lower third and I have a logo and I want to be able to swap that logo out. But it's so much more. So let's just start with a kind of a small use case. Like I made a title for an episodic series that I've been working on called Pet Wars, The Cutest Battle. Like who are cuter, cats or dogs? I don't know. Y'all want to fight about it? Because I can't choose. Don't make me choose. So I've got, you know, basically I've got this title. I've got this really cool little kitty cat and doggy coming in. And okay, cool. That's awesome. But what if I, you know, have another series? The show changes. Maybe that show got canceled, but I really like this design. I don't want to lose it. So I'm going to show you how fast we can sort of iterate on this. I've got a new show. This one is about space. So I'm gonna bring this primary comp, as we call them. That's essentially like, this is the comp that has all of these parameters. And if you look here, now we go down in here, and I can open this up, and there's this new parameter here called the essential properties. And it is a mirror image of everything that I had in the essential graphics panel. So let's do a couple things here. First of all, I gotta make this a little bit bigger. And maybe we change the color up. I'm really into hot pink these days. And then, you know, the show's changed. Like, this is not the name of the show anymore. So we're just gonna edit this real quick. Do a little space rocks. Okay. Let's bring in this guy that I got off of Adobe stock. This guy, he has some dance moves, but wait, like, he's blocking everything. So what do I do? This is how simple it is. That, when I dragged and dropped that new video that I replaced, it creates a new comp that now I can do whatever you would want to do in a comp. I can add a quick key light to this. Just gonna green screen that out super fast. Okay, there he is. And we can just check this out real fast, see how that looks. He's dancing, he's basically positioned well. It's really that quickly to iterate. We've been working with the Essential Graphics panel, talking about essential properties, which I love, but we also are gonna talk about 3D. We've created a better ways to work, better ways to understand where your layers are. So here I've got this cute little scene going on, but maybe I want to try to understand the depth of my layers and where they're all falling. So the first thing we want to do is enable Draft 3D. And once that's enabled, we can enable the 3D ground plane, which is going to show us sort of where we are in space. I'm going to use this new tool, which is like basically allows us to orbit around the scene, and you can see the ground there. And then there's this new thing, which is new to this release in 22.3, which is the extended viewer. So this really helps you see what's outside of the active camera. You know, you can basically move this around. This orbits around the cursor. It just essentially helps you figure out where you are in space, which can be a challenge when you're working in 3D. So at the end of the day, I hope I've shown you some good new tricks, some good new hacks. I'm really excited about the work that we've done. We've been working hard to make things faster for you and also a little bit easier to take some of that redundancy away so you can get back to the creative stuff. Thank you so much for your time, and y'all have a good rest of your NAB. Thanks.